Good morning and welcome to Cambrils on our last full day, Friday morning. Overcast, as you can see, a couple of spots of rain, but you know, it looks
lovely palm
trees. You can see sun in the distance, and hey, it's not raining. Raining a lovely place at this beach work any day of the week. So,
just got off that bus.
Yeah. And we're off into the centre, which has got a little harbour, lovely little restaurants, local shops. It's a really nice place, Cambrils.
Love it. If you think you've not seen a lot of us on this vlog, or any of the other vlogs, it's because we like to film what we can see. So you can see, just in case you fancy coming, because there's so many beautiful places to come in Costa Dorada. Fancy it?
Yep.
I'm going to try and show you a little bit of what there is. So you don't want to see our faces. You want to see what's here.
Exactly. Looking at what's going on is a lot better than our faces. So, and plus, you get a better feeling for what we're looking at, and what we're seeing.
Yeah, because the 47 bus goes back to Salou, as is number 5. You can see it tells you on the front of the buses where they stop. But it's got Salou. Pineda. It's quite helpful.
We're staying at Cap Salou, which is between Salou and La Pineda, so you know if it's got those two on, it will stop in between. We'll head on to the harbour, the marina.
Yeah.
These stairs randomly go to a lot in Spain. There's always parking. Well, a lot of the parking's underground, which is a really good way of doing it, because then you don't clutter up. Yeah, exactly. You have these wide areas to walk, because the cars are all underground, keeping cool, as Elizabeth says. Yeah. And you don't get that congestion. Very clever way.
Yeah.
We try and film, we try and take a photo. We always manage to time it so a truck or a van or a coach comes right in the way. That coastline is beautiful, we went past that, it's on the way down to Valencia down there. Okay. This is Port Cambrils.
Oh, quite a good photo. Well, there you go. Got you yet. There you go.
Elizabeth thinks I'm a total boy looking at maps, so she's run off heading to the sea, waiting for the cars to stop. Here we are. Oh, Cambrils. Oh, we've got a double-decker carousel.
Ooh. Quiet. We've got aileron there, look.
Oh, yeah, just above. I'll have to go and have a look at that, because that's somewhere, I think, one of the landmarks I remember.
Devon. Yeah,
the
last one in Devon, isn't it?
That's right.
Aileron. This is Friday. In Cambrils at
half past ten.
End of season. Pretty quiet. A lot quiet, to be honest. Yeah. I'm just hoping. Yes, there you go. Just some filming.
Just look like we've just been talking. It does look like it's closing up for the season, which we know we're here kind of the last week.
But, yeah, we
Last week. Yeah. I wish you wake up the mind how they're spelling stuff, because that says La Dorada. Yeah, we've seen everything from D-O-R to D-A-U-R. Yeah.
It's confusing.
Confusing.
Try to tag something.
Yeah. Playing havoc with Elizabeth's Instagram. Yeah.
Yeah, there's houses again. Cambrils, €25,000. Nice view out actually. That's got 193,000 euros. Yeah, nice. Yeah, that one. A bit more at that price range. Well, they all are, to be honest, but. Yeah. Only one bedroom, that one. And that's 139. Yeah, this one. I've got four bedrooms. 25. So yeah. I don't understand, but must be the areas. Obviously, we don't know the areas. We should look in the, you know, for somewhere to purchase then.
Yeah. So you're very local. This is nice, actually. There's not a lot of tourist shops. Fish markets and stuff like that, so we'll try and find one. But we'll find something lovely, but yeah.
If it was open, the seafront looks like it's got lots of places to eat, and look at that view.
Yeah.
You know, that view was amazing.
Cheers.
Can you just imagine sitting out here in a nice hot summer's day, not when it's raining, a nice hot summer's day, looking out here. And from Cap Salou to Cambrils, it was only, what, 2.70 on the bus, 2.70?
Yeah. Something like that.
Don't know how much it'll be on the way back because you like to change the prices. But for almost €3.
Yeah.
2.70. Not bad.
Right.
Like sightseeing.
Yeah.
Walking around.
And like many of these little
Petrus.
Yeah, and these little harbour places, fishing villages. McDonald's has moved in as well further down, so if you actually must have something that you know what you're getting, there is that option as well here.
Yeah, because we don't know, some, you know, when you're overseas you want to try different food, sometimes you think, oh, no, I've got to try that fish dish because you just don't know.
Yeah.
But if you go to McDonald's, then they've got a wider range of food at McDonald's as well, haven't they?
Yeah, they have. Yeah, it's a lot nicer.
Bigger menu and everything. And you do know what you're getting.
Yeah.
So, not saying never eat overseas food when you're overseas.
No.
But if you've got anybody in your party that's like gluten-free or get anything like that,
you know you're
going to get something.
Yeah.
Whereas here, because you'd have to really brush up on your Spanish. I know that it's sang gluten into it, or sing gluten.
Sing gluten, yeah.
But yeah, right. We've got our little things to help you, accessible.
Yeah, and it's looked like it's brightening up over there as well.
Yeah, it does.
Which is good
it?
To see.
Yeah. Lots of boxes.
Yeah, lots. Yeah, you'll see that flashing green sign if you've never been here before.
And when you describe medication, which is making me smile.
Yeah, when you're trying to describe what you want.
I was describing an Alka-Seltzer, and I said, I need something, she goes poof, in the water.
Yeah.
She laughed, she exactly what I meant.
Yeah. Those of you who have seen me laughing at this sign, which is obviously all about the beach, but the one in particular that I thought was never really thought of with regards to the beach, which is there.
Don't give massages out.
You're forbidden to deliver massage services.
Wow.
Yes. It's a sad beach, not a happy beach.
The dog, I thought it was like, no, a dog, but apparently it's consult information services.
Yeah, so also the dogs tell you what to do around here.
We have to learn Spanish. Yeah. Forbidden peddling.
Yeah, oh yes, yeah.
Yes.
Forbidden peddling. Can't
lie. Although I don't think people actually take notice of that.
No, they don't.
You've not seen any here?
Yeah.
But in Salou, there's quite a lot of peddlers.
Yeah.
But
wow.
No cleaners.
No cleaners. Don't need it, the beach is nice and clean, look at that.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Just been playing with the crossing, filming it because it's quite funny. You'll see the film. But here's Elizabeth. Got it all.
Show you.
Beautiful beach. Let's stand on the edge trying to fall off it.
Steps down.
Yeah, steps down, big steps.
Yeah.
Big steps. Like big steps and you can't lie.
Actually, we don't want any steps,
naturally. We've done your steps.
like 20,000 a day. Fireworks and all that. What's that mean? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'd be getting the Kevin badge and the Stuart badge and all sorts.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was, we set off at a hell of a pace, but thank you. That first day we went to Tarragona. When we couldn't get into the hotel because obviously it's an early arrival, everybody else kind of sat around the pool and whatever, which is fair enough, but we got out, it's felt a lot longer holiday from actually getting out and going and seeing something.
First day, yeah.
Yeah, and making the most of the time.
Yeah. Sierra, so we've got beach here. Then we've got. Promenade to walk on. Then all the shops that are down there as well. Plenty of crossings, drop curves and things like that. But yeah, got lovely beach. Very quiet. Yeah, and from Cambrils, next place is?
Saloon. And we walked it once in the baking heat, thinking that it was about 10 minutes. It turned out to be about at least half an hour. Doable.
Could have been slightly longer than half an hour. I think that's optimistic. It is doable. Just know that you're going to be doing it and don't wear your best sandals.
Yes.
Yeah, so like I said, there's a promenade down here to walk on, and shops which are usually open in the height of summer, and lots of places to eat as well. And there is, as always, in the distance,
a McDonald's
that does have a varied menu in there, different to what you can see at home. I see that on an early vlog of ours. But the beaches here in Costa Dorada are very clean, they're very lovely, very big. They are lovely. Thank you.
We found McDonald's coffee with ice cream, haven't
you? Oh yeah, it's absolutely delicious.
Seems like just a shot of coffee with Mr. Whippy on top.
Oh yeah. But it is absolutely amazing. We might have just said a same thank you there. There's a guy walking towards us, and although we don't ask people to move out of the way when we're filming, he actually did. Because the thing is, if you're filming, you film if people walk in front of you, they walk in front of you. One of those things.
Yeah.
But the guy did move out, and he was very smiley about
it,
wasn't he?
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah. But there you go. Not consistent prices, very good, very, very regular, very clean. You have to wear a face mask. But Cap Salou to Port Cambrils, £2.55 per person. Going back, £2.40 per person. Same day, couple hours apart. So the buses, very regular, very good, very clean. The prices, think of a number. So always make sure you have at least €5, €6 to come back and to travel, because they're not going to charge the same. £2.55, that was at 9:41 on the 7th of October, and then you got 11:40, 2:40, again on the 7th of October. Ideal way to travel around the resort, cheap as anything.
So, as you know, that's the Cala Font, our hotel. If you walk through the side gates, you can just see that you can walk down here to the beach, although we'd recommend walking along and going down the steps, because where those guys are walking up, it's quite slippy. But if you walk over here, that is a public toilet, believe it or not. There is a lovely little coastal path we're just going to walk along that goes around to the next hotel, the Best Cap Salou. We went there the other day, just to see actually whether we could view a room, because we've always stayed at the Cala Font and there's nothing wrong with it, but we thought in a contingency if it was ever booked up or we just fancied a change, we wondered what this one was like, and unfortunately they're a little bit sniffy. Apparently they were fully booked up, which we know is a load of rubbish, because the Cala Font. Yeah, the Cala Font is nowhere near, and we've seen that there's loads of empty rooms in this one because we overlook it.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a lie, so that's a minus point. But then apparently only 10% of their rooms have got a sea view.
And the reserve there for people who are here for 2 weeks. If you're here for 1 week, you're not going to get a sea view.
Yeah. Which is a bit off. Yeah. I mean, I know California, you have to pay more to get a sea view, but at least you know you're guaranteed, obviously, the rooms being available, you're guaranteed by paying. Another little lizard there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow, it's a big lizard.
Yeah, it was a big one. Yeah, you're guaranteed to get that that view. So, yeah, a couple of minus points. It does look more geared for kids. So if you've got young kids, best Cap Salou might be better for you because it's got a fantastic big water park.
Yeah.
And this is a public beach. So while it backs into the bottom of their hotel here, this is a fully public use beach that you can get down to via some steps over there. Through this way, through the walkway here, which we're going to do. You can actually be cheeky and even walk through the hotel if you want, and through reception, which...
But we're not going to film.
No, we're not going to film. We might do it, but we won't film it. we just come from the beach, which is down there. I was saying, this is their hotel, which isn't that private. And then up here to the top. Found some more steps. We love steps. This holiday, we seem to have cornered the market on steps. This thing takes you down. If we go walking that way for about a mile, you get to La Pineda. You come down here, you're going to the centre of the Cap Salou village. So these are obviously the only ones that have got sea views. There are a few over the other side and those at the end, but there's not many of them. And as you can see, yeah, because even these that face this way, it's only a partial sea view. That's it. It's mostly a view of views. So again, with best Cap Salou, what we were saying, only 10% overlook the sea. These overlook the little village centre.
Amazing.
Yeah. And they said, yeah, if you've got young kids, as I just said, the water park looks amazing. It's got slides and everything. It does look cool. So if your kids are that age, maybe think of this one over Cala Font, to be honest with you, which does seem to attract a more an older set.
It attracts a family. So
yeah.
It's a nice place to visit.
Oh, absolutely.
And there are other hotels in the area. There's the Grasse, isn't
there? Yeah, Grasse is just down the road.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're back in the room. I'm just picking up from where we were saying about the best Cap Salou. Obviously down there is the beach that we walked across. That's that little coastal path that we mentioned. And from here, as you can see, these sets of rooms that are in front of us here, they're not too bad. They overlook this hotel and the sea and the view behind. But then there's a load that are behind this lovely block of apartments. And while the apartments overlook some of our rooms over here, there's obviously a road's width between them, quite a distance. Whereas the distance between the best Cap Salou and those apartments is, what, 10, 15 feet? It's not very far at all, which didn't make that very appealing. So unless you've got one of these rooms here, which are okay, and the bit that juts out that we saw previously that overlooks that beach there, you really are skipped for a view on that one. So it looks classy, you've got to see from here. The verandas that they've got, the little areas, are probably better looking than ours. But yeah, they've tried to make that their own private beach, and as you saw, it's not as a public beach, just that it's very open access. Our pool, etc., has got a lifeguard sat in front of it, and a door that he controls or is on a key system with the room key. So nobody can come in, use our facilities, use our pool or anything, unless you've either got a key, or you can prove that you're staying here with the lifeguard. Whereas, as you saw, we could have walked right through the hotel off that beach and not challenged. Yeah, right, we've just come out of the doorway. Just I'll zoom in and say just there, and we're gonna walk down to this little beach. Beautiful house there. Now, we said earlier on you can go down that ramp, but it's a bit slippy.
Yeah.
So we are going to go to.
You've got prams.
Yep.
To go down there, obviously.
Yep.
There's a wheelchair that's selected, but it is slippery.
Yeah, yeah, and as you can see, I'm just going to go over to it because it is quite steep, yes, as you can see. Just a bit of gradient, but like as I say, fantastic if you've got prams, etc. But we're going to go over here back of the hotel.
Yep.
Now, years and years back, we'll just actually pause here, because they've just taken where that's all churned up there. That's where they had a like
bar.
A beach bar, and where they kept sunbeds, etc.
Mojitos.
Yeah, it says years ago, when we first got coming here, this cave was used as a storage for beer, wines, Stirlingham, because they used to be quite a big structure here. There used to be a bar, but that went, I don't know whether it was blown away or just taken away. But there we go.
Yeah.
A bit cold.
Not as cold as the pool, though.
No, not as cold as the pool. Yeah. Ooh, I don't know, though.
Oh, no, no, no.
Oh.
No.
But
it's not deep.
Yeah, it's not deep. No, you can pretty much go right back to where that.
Those two people.
Yeah, yeah, those two people are, yeah.
They're still
standing. Yeah, 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 pretty much you can stand up right way out there. So, beautiful, isn't it? Here goes Elizabeth. Yeah, this is just.
So this is the new part of the. Not been in here before. We've got a ice hockey table.
Yep.
I think.
Yeah, exactly. Last time we were here, this was a storage room, wasn't it?
It was. Yeah, yeah.
So as you can see, look.
There's something to do with it, to be honest.
Yeah, there's a lot of room, actually, space.
Yeah.
Got a couple of grab machines. A couple of pool tables.
This machine here.
All right. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
Good.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Is that the pool?
You certainly can.
Yeah. Look, the pool there.
Yeah.
With a wiggly giggly on there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just you come out of this room, we've got a gym, which is free to use. You just need to collect the key from reception.
Yeah. And it is yeah, that's for the key at reception.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Which is pretty well equipped for a free, again, another free piece of your facility.
Yeah.